G'day guys and welcome to Primal Waters. Today we're going to have a look at an island called St. Paul. It's located in between South Africa and Western Australia. The reason why I'm doing a video on this today is because we've talked about in the past about where can these mega sharks exist, where can they be located around the world if not in populated areas. Now there's lots of isolated islands that have scattered throughout the planet. And this one today we're gonna have a closer look at. I had a look on some information on Wikipedia, and had a look at the temperature, what type of food sources could a mega shark need to survive on this island. And like I said, we'll have a quick chat about it. I reckon this is a perfect location. We've talked about great white sharks migration. And we do know that some great whites have been tagged in West Australia and have popped up in South Africa. So if you look at the locations, it's probably dead set in the middle. The temperature-wise for this island, St. Paul, is averaged around about 14 degrees Celsius. It's labelled as a subtropical island as well, which is quite unusual. Now, reason why... If you even have a look at the island itself, it looks so prehistoric. It once was a volcano on here. Apparently, it erupted about in the late 1700s. You can see the mass destruction to the island. I think going by the original photo of it, it's pretty much been cut in half. So it looks very prehistoric, very Jurassic World. And just seeing this like little lake where the crater or where the volcano once was, it looks very, very prehistoric. And look at these little dots along here as well. Now, the island isn't populated. The island was discovered back in 1559. Throughout then, it was rediscovered over a few years or decades. It's owned by the French. There also is another island north of it, about 80 k's. It's called Amsterdam Island. Now, that island is populated. I'm not sure on how many people actually live on that island. It's more mainly scientists and stuff like that. Now, the animals that are actually on this island itself, where have I lost you, are actually... a breeding site for southern elephant whales, southern elephant seals, and also fur seals as well. So it's got a food source for mega sharks. Now, I've tried to find any information. I've seen some videos on YouTube of the island. It looks like it's an island that you're not allowed to go on or you need to have permission on. There was one video... where one of a research vessel and a helicopter just orbited around the island. They didn't land on it or anything like this. So it just makes you think you're not allowed on it. Now, throughout the years, the island, or back in the early 1700s and stuff like that, or even before that, there was a lot of shipwrecks that took place around here. Survivors would end up on this island and would have to wait for ages to be rescued. It did have a settlement on here for a while. A lot of seal hunting and stuff like that took place throughout this island as well. So, but any more information you want to read on this island itself, I'll provide the links in the description bar down below. I'll even put some videos I found on YouTube as well. It looks fantastic. Like, if I can bring up one of the images right now, that's one part of the island. I think that's the that's the rock part. It's actually looking in this direction here into this little bay area. So see the big rock there? That's that here. So have a look at it. It just looks, wow. I would love to be able to go and check this island out. It looks very prehistoric. Now, mega sharks, great whites. I actually put a tweet out there on Twitter. I'm not sure if it's going to get answered, but if anyone knows any information where I can actually go and find out more about this island, So we do know fur seals, elephant seals are on this island. We don't know what's actually in the waters around this island. But I did see a video also about Amsterdam, and there were killer whales. So we probably know that killer whales frequent this water, obviously for the fur seals and elephant seals. Now, I would have to imagine there would be great whites off this island. It would have to be. It's in... I'm not sure what the water temperature is, but going by the location in line with South Africa and Western Australia, subtropical climate, average temperature of 14 Celsius, I can imagine there would be white sharks around here. It would have to be. Can you imagine what type of sharks actually frequent this water? It just looks like a perfect spot for a mega shark to exist, actually. You know, we talk about... sightings of mega sharks that date back 100 years on mainlands, but can you imagine what actually lives around this island? I would love to be. I've tried to find as much information as I can, but there's not a lot. Like, has anyone actually explored these waters around the island? Like, I can just imagine now that there's great whites that no one's ever seen that live on this island, not live on it, but live around this island in these waters and stuff like that. So, but I just, it does, it looks very prehistoric. I love to look at it. I can just imagine all the seals along these rocky beds here, along the coastline. And out through here, great whites patrol. One video, that's actually kelp or seaweed. That's actually seaweed, I think. I did see a video I watched of a sailboat that went past here, and they videoed it. I will link that down below. And all they talked about was how much seaweed was in the water. So I can assume that's seaweed. And if that's the case, that's probably a good spot to for seals to hide. But I can just imagine there'd be so many seals along these islands here. So, but yeah, I wanted to share this video with you today because I did mention this the other day in part 3 of my search for mega shark locations. Perfect spot for these sharks to exist. Perfect spot because people don't live here. There's no one around. It's an isolated area, part of the world. It's in a prime location, Western Australia, in between South Africa and Western Australia. Right here. Over here is these mega shark stories. Look at, and the island's over here. So, yeah, have a look at that. Right there and there. Perfect location. Perfect. So what I am going to do is that I'm going to go look for other isolated islands that have dotted throughout the planet, and just highlight, look at them, research them. But I'm going to definitely look more into these islands, and hopefully I can find somewhere where I can actually see if anyone's actually checked these waters out. Around St. Paul and Amsterdam as well. So, but this island here is my main focus. So, all right, guys, that's it for this video. Like I said, I will provide the links down below so you can have a look at the island yourself and have a read about it and see some videos. It's very unique, and I would love to be able to go out somewhere like this to explore. Love to know if anyone has actually checked the waters out around this island to see what animals are down there, what type of marine animals. So, all right, guys, that's it for this video. Thank you for tuning in. Drop a comment down below, hit that like button, share this video. And if you're new to this channel, please subscribe. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next video.